Now this is a preview unboxing video, but I do have sample video like you're watching right now at the end, a little bit more of it actually. And I do explain and show you this product and I unbox it and I talk a little bit about the main concepts of this product, the Insta360 X4. But to be honest, the most important part is really going to be, what does it look like? What does the footage look like? And that's probably why you're here, not to hear me ramble on and try to figure out how to turn the power on and that kind of thing. Yeah, I had a little bit of a brain fart partway through this video. I would just suggest, if that's not that important to you, then just go to the end. There's some nice sample video. Went for a nice ride on my UC with my wife and a good friend, and I got some good video, and I'd love to share it with you. So just bypass all the rambling and go to the end if that's important to you. Hello, everybody. It's Michael from Get Fit Over 40, and I have here in front of me the Insta360 X4, and this is an unboxing preview. So my idea here is to unbox it, just give you my first impressions, take a look in the box, maybe a couple explanations of what this product exactly is, just for those that don't know about it too much yet. And hopefully at the end, I'll put in a little bit of video of it in action, doing what it does best, recording literally all the action around it in super high resolution. All right, so really quickly, what is this? This is a 360 camera, so it has a lens on either side. So if you flip it over, it's gonna have a lens. Well, you can see that's one side, that's the other side, lens on either side. And one lens records in 4K, the other records in 4K. Previous version to this, the X3 recorded in 5.7K instead of 8K. So each lens was doing almost 3K, just under 3K. So there's a significant bump in resolution and it does make a difference. Plus, basically the processor in it has been upgraded. Just about everything about this camera has been upgraded over the previous version, including the screen size, how much battery life you get, just processing features, frame rates, all kinds of stuff. You can watch a lot of other people's videos. They go into a lot of detail about exactly what the improvements are with this camera. But the idea here is to be able to literally put this camera on the end of a stick, a selfie stick, you extend that out, and it records everything around you. So you don't have to decide what you want to record. You kind of decide later on what you want to frame and put in view, because obviously people aren't watching at home with 360 goggles on. So you have to kind of put what they'd normally see in front of a screen, which is just one screen and not everything around them, right? So that's kind of what the plan is here, is with this, is to record in 360, get everything, and then later on decide what I want to share. And you can do that in the 360 app. There's an app on your phone. There's an app that you can download for your computer that allows you to do all kinds of crazy manipulation of that 360 video later on. You can also record in this one really cool way. It's called Me Mode, where it uses both lenses, but it only really records in one lens at a time. And as, say, it goes and you flip over, let's say you move the camera around or you go around to the other side, it'll just follow you and it tracks you. So it basically tracks you and just follows you. It's all about you or me, right? And that's a neat way to create video without having to go in later on and do a lot of editing. So let's open this box, take a look. If I can, this knife is huge. Okay. And by the way, I'm using my new camera, my Sony ZV-1. Hopefully I've got all the settings the way I need them to be, because I've never actually used it for something like this. I've used it a little bit, but I haven't done a product video yet. So hopefully I've got everything set up so that this product video looks good. So let's take a quick look at the box here. You got your 8K 360, 8K 30 frames per second, 5.7K at 60 frames per second. So that's an improvement over the previous version, because the previous version could only do 30 frames. You've got shoot first, yeah, frame later. That's what I was talking about. You've got, what is that here? Yeah, the invisible selfie stick. So that's just the way that this camera captures video using both lenses. It can get rid of that selfie stick, so it just looks like the camera's floating in midair. You've got active HDR, so if you want to get that super dynamic range, and that's usually a little bit better indoors. You don't need it as much outdoors. And then you have this flow state stabilization, so everything stays ultra stabilized when you record in 360. So yeah, on the other side, 720, 72 megapixel photos. Yeah, pretty crazy. 4K 60 single lens mode. So if you just want to use one lens, you can record in 4K with that lens. You got removable lens guards that come with this one, so you don't scratch your lenses up like the previous version did not have those. And so if you scratched up a lens, you had to get a new camera. Now you can just replace that removable lens cover. Waterproof to 10 meters and AI powered editing. So there's lots of power in the processor in here and on the cameras and in software to do all kinds of manipulation later on. That's super cool. All right, So here we have it. This is it's a decent size. It's not a little camera. So that's the one downside is, you know, sometimes if you need more battery life, higher, you know, higher frame rates, higher everything, you got to put a little more inside to get it to do that. So they did make this version slightly bigger than the previous version, but not by a lot. So here's the lens covers, or the lens, this is covered, but they're not the lens covers, sorry. So we got these little sticky things here. Let's take that off. So there's your one side 360 lens, right? Put that off. Okay, so there's the other 360 lens, obviously. We're just gonna strip this down. And here's a 2.5-inch LCD screen. I think this battery, okay, well, we'll take that off, why not? I'm gonna turn it on. Hopefully it's got enough juice in it that it can turn on. Hopefully, maybe not. Maybe that's another video later on. Maybe I need to read the instructions. Maybe the battery needs to come out. Is there something on the battery? No. Holding it down. It's usually how you start something. Okay, it looks like there's no juice in this, so I'm gonna have to juice it up. So this is just an unboxing video. I'll have to do a video where maybe I go through the menus and stuff later and show you that. But the screen is a beautiful screen. I've seen it in other people's videos. It's too bad it doesn't have enough juice to get her going. What comes in the box here? We'll look at that real quick. So, all right. So you got this nice little case, really nice case. So you can put it in the case there. That way it's not going to scratch it up too much in your pocket. And you get a little USB cable. So it's a USB-C to USB-C cable, okay? And then you have a cleaning cloth. And then you have, this is, it looks like it's a case, and I guess it is kind of a case because it protects the edges. But apparently this is to dissipate heat. So, but I'll probably put it on there because, you know, it's covering all the edges where if you drop it, that's probably what's going to hit first. So that's kind of a cool thing. We'll definitely probably put that on. I don't know which way it goes. I guess it goes on the back side. Kind of like that. Okay, yeah, super easy. That wasn't hard, right? I really wish this would turn on. Maybe I need to do a magic double press. No, long press. Yeah, how about I plug it in? Maybe I can trick it. Oh, we got some juice going in there. Let's see if we can turn it on now. It looks okay. So it says it's 75% charged. So I'm obviously not powering this up the right way. I guess it's time to read the manual. Okay, I am an idiot. I just assumed that was the power button. But look over here. So maybe we should have done a little walk around first. So you have here a microphone. There's different microphones and things here. There's your power button, okay? So 360 didn't blow it. You've got the SD card slot right there. Or not, sorry, the USB card there, or power in. And then I think the card reader is inside here. Yeah, so your card reader goes right here, okay? So it's hidden in the battery area, which is nice and secure, okay? And so you wanna make sure there's no red there when you close that up. So charging right here, unless you have a different type of charger. SD card goes in the battery compartment area. These are obviously menu buttons and things like that for screen control. And then here we have the actual power button. Okay, there it is. Look at that. So it's going to want me to download the app, which I've already downloaded. I'm not going to set this up on screen or do any of that funky stuff because that's not what this video is about. This isn't a show you how to use it video and tell you everything about all the details. This is just so you get an idea what it looks like. It doesn't look like I'm going to be able to do anything else until I get past the screen and set it up and pair it with my app, which I'll do later on. But what I want to do is I want to end this video with a little bit of footage. And my plan is to, hopefully tomorrow, I'm going to get out of my UC and do a little bit of riding and just get something there to share with you, even if it's a little bit of stuff. That's the plan. But really nice little camera, as you can see. It feels great in the hand. It's very high quality, just feeling it and holding it. A little bigger than I thought it would be, but it's not crazy heavy or anything like that. So this is going to be a lot of fun. Did I miss anything? I don't think I did. We've got, obviously, there's all these little instructions and manuals and things like that that come with it. Oh, yeah. Another thing that came in the box, which is kind of neat, is it comes with some stickers that were just, they weren't in the box. They were packaged with it. So it was in a box. And in that box was this guy here. It's from Insta360 community, I guess, some sort of Insta360 sticker. So, yeah, we'll stick those on things. All right. So very cool. Lots of stuff, lots to play with. This is going to be really cool. This is going to help me make even better videos. That's the plan, is to just, I've been upgrading a lot of my cameras and stuff lately, and the plan is to just keep continuing to make videos and just make better quality videos for everybody. All right, thanks for watching, and enjoy the videos that I'm going to share with you right now.